genuinely, I'm feeling extremely, extremely good to be here. It's an honor. And I was just talking to the translator that I feel like saying that so strong has been the cultural expression of Ranjit that I would love to claim that I am both Kala and Kabali. Even Vaanam is celebrating today. Friends, youth movement is greatly responding to the fascism at this point of history on Indian soil. And many of the youth leaders in this country are rejected and discarded by the Hindutva fascist forces as anti-nationals. But what is anti-national? To put it into the words of Baba Saheb Ambedkar, he said in one of his historic speeches that caste is anti-national. What is anti-national is caste. There are people who've been claiming that only they know what is patriotism. Actually, the ones who are claiming this have no respect for the Indian constitution, have no respect of its spirit of creating a secular socialist republic. They are claiming this. And that is where Baba Saheb comes into play. He says, what are you talking? Where is the nation? We are a nation in making. We think in terms of caste. We interpret in terms of caste. We marry as per caste. Caste is a phenomenon which has distorted every facet and dimension of life in India. How can we claim to be a nation? We are a nation in making. So, until the caste is thrown permanently into the history of dustbin, we will not become a nation. And for the project of annihilation of caste, the agenda of social justice and cultural movement, cultural revolution is vital. The expression of blue that we see in Ranjit's movies and in n number of demonstrations and rallies and processions of dharnas and agitations and movements across the country, across the world, by the subaltern masses, amongst the Dalit movement, it has given us a sense of empowerment. We cherish blue like anything. So, the point that I want to make is, man, human being, is not a logical category. We are very emotional people. And therefore, we love literature, poetry, theater, cinema. And through these mediums, we need to propagate our agenda of creating a new society. And that is where this festival is extremely important. I am so much happy to be here, as I've been pointing out, that next year I would love to do volunteer in this kind of film festival, this kind of theater and musical festival. In fact, it is my proposal to all of you, to Ranjit, to all the activist people, to all of you, that why can't next year we can have India's biggest subaltern theater, music and film festival collectively. That will be our response to the fascist forces who are using saffron for their divisive agenda. In Tamil Nadu, few days back, I was at Coimbatore, and I just came to know, it is extremely shocking, between 2016 to 2018, during this period of 2 years, 13 Dalit and Adivasi girls have been sexually abused, raped and killed. It is most shocking. And still, the kind of response it should have generated from the people of Tamil Nadu in South India and from all over the country, it has not. We see the recent case of Sanjali. She's burnt alive. One teenage girl was beheaded recently in Tamil Nadu. This is most shocking. So, with every passing day, the penetration of Hindutvavadi fascist forces is creating havoc, particularly for the minorities and Dalits. So, with every passing day, we also need to come up with our own colors. We also need to come up with our own music and poetry and theater and cinema. But when I say we, I don't mean just Dalits. I mean all the lower caste, lower class sections of the society. Because by caste, Periyar was also not scheduled caste. That is what we have to remember always. And my big salute, the intensity and energy with which I say Jai Bhim, with the same intensity and energy, I say Jai Bhagat Singh and salute to Ramaswamy Periyar as well. The way he has attacked Manuvad, Brahminism from the land of Tamil Nadu, and the way he could catch people's imagination all over the country, become the voice of the voiceless people, he's been a great figure. The similar kind of, I just said a look at one of the sculptures. I was introduced to one Mr. James. And so big has been his contribution. It's incredible. He, as a district collector, granted lakhs of acres of land to the landless people. And nobody talks about him. Am I right? He has granted lakhs and lakhs of acres of land. Friends, we must understand this socio-cultural response, socio-cultural movement is extremely important. Suppose hypothetically, she is wearing a blue t-shirt. It's an expression. But if her body is malnourished, then what? If I'm holding a blue flag, if I'm doing a march with a blue flag in my hand, but if I'm malnourished, if I'm not having bread, if I'm not having roti, if I'm not having shelter, then what do I do about it? So we need blue, not just to respond culturally, socially, but also for our economic material struggle. That we must not forget. And that's why, as I think of Mr. James, one name occurs to my mind is that of Dada Saheb Gaikwad. Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, during later years of his life, realized that he couldn't do much for the landless people. Every day in India, 3 Dalit women are raped. 3-4 Dalits are killed every single day. A crime against a Dalit is committed every 18 minutes. Who are the victims of these caste brutalities and violence? In 95% cases, maybe even 99% cases, all of them are working class Dalits. Middle class Dalits may have to face some sort of caste bias and discrimination in their offices, as a bank employee, as a government employee, as a teacher, as a professor, as a journalist, maybe even as a politician. But it is only and only and only and only and only working class, poorest of poor Dalit who are subjected to all brutalities and violence. They are the ones who are raped, physically assaulted and killed. So what does it show? It shows that India is just not a caste-ridden society. It is a combination of caste and class. It is this upper caste, upper class combination which is ruling over the lower class combination. So, this lower class sections of the society have to rise with blue, but also raising their material issue. Dada Sahab Gaikwad was told by Baba Sahab Ambedkar that I couldn't do much for the landless people. You start some movement. He was wearing a dhoti. He was not very sophisticated. He was not graduate or PhD or doctorate or nothing. He was a dhoti wearing grassroots activist. Inspired by Baba Sahab Ambedkar, starts a massive movement in Maharashtra and ensures lakhs and lakhs of acres of land to the landless Dalit. But nobody remembers his name. He's forgotten like Mr. James. So, we will have our poetry, we will have our blue, we will have our cinema, we will have our kala, we will have our kabali, we will have our Vaan festival. At the same time, we will ask for material resources, we will ask for minerals, we will ask for land, we will ask for wealth. This nation belongs to we the people, and we are part of it, and therefore we will claim each and everything. Even at the risk of sounding a bit repetitive, I will make one more point. Assume for the sake of argument that X, Y, Z are Dalits living in slums of Dharavi, Mumbai, and the walls and the roofs of the slums are blue. What do we do? We do celebrate blue. We are happy that blue is there on our wall. But then we want proper shelter as well. We want 2 BHK. We want 3 BHK. We want 5 BHK. I hope I am conveyed. This is the point. Now there could be a debate. Like we have a debate between lefts and Ambedkarites. Caste struggle first. First, what should be the goal? Annihilation of caste? Another would say, no. Annihilation of class. Caste and class are interconnected. So, why can't we have both together? Struggle against caste and class both go hand in hand. Same way, cultural movement with progressive content and struggle for economic rights both go hand in hand. So, we will celebrate and cherish our blue. We will also ask for our roti, kapda and makan. That is the point that I want to make. I conclude with an appeal that the way we celebrate 14th April, annihilation of caste without intercaste marriages is not possible. And for intercaste marriages, falling in love is vital. Therefore, celebrate not just 14th April, but also 14th February, Valentine's Day as well. So, read, write poetry, write literature, watch movies, do theatre, love, make love, fall in love, go for intercaste marriages, annihilate caste, and let us create new India. Thank you so much. Jai Bhim.